Hello friends, welcome to English for Competitive Exams. My name is Suresh. In this class, let's try to understand four modal auxiliaries and their real life uses. Can, could, may and might. Right? So in the last class, we understood that modal auxiliaries are used to express different modalities like permissions and requests and possibilities. Right? So we will try to understand each of these four modal auxiliaries today and different use cases in real life. Okay, so before we begin, let's try to understand four basic rules which are applicable and common for all modal auxiliaries. So these are the rules. So modal auxiliaries are always followed by base form of the verb or V1, you can say V1. So you don't say Ken sang, you will only say Ken sing. You won't say Ken sung, you only say Ken and sing. See some example. You don't say I can to sing, you only say I can sing. So it's always followed by base form. Similarly, the second rule, it is same for all pronouns. So when we learnt about simple present tense, we said for each pronoun, the verb may take or may not take yes. Sing, if you take for example, when I use I as the subject, I say I sing. If I use he or she as the subject, we should say she sings or he sings. We add s to the verb because it is third person singular and the tense is simple present tense. Whereas in the sentence I can sing, it will not change even if I change the subject. For example, I can sing, she can sing, he can sing, you can sing, we can sing. Irrespective of the subject, irrespective of the pronoun we are using, it will not take yes. So it remains same for all pronouns and any person. You don't say she can sing. You don't add this yes here. She can sing. Similarly, while forming negatives and questions also, you don't need any other helping verbs. In the sentence I sing, if I want to make it a negative, I will write it like I do not sing. Right? I will take the help of the auxiliary verb do, add not, and then say I do not sing. But when you are using modal auxiliaries, they can take negatives directly. They don't need any other auxiliary verbs. In the sentence she can sing, the negative is she cannot sing. You don't need to take the help of do. She cannot sing. You don't need she does not can sing. This is wrong. Same holds true for could, may, might and any of the modal auxiliaries. And one more important thing, they don't combine with any other modal auxiliaries. You will not have can and could in the same sentence. You will not have may and might in the same sentence. Right, in the same sentence, they do not combine. They don't come adjacent to each other. You see, she will can sing, looks odd, right? It is wrong. You only say she can sing. She would can sing, she may can sing. All these things are wrong. So they don't combine with any other modal auxiliaries. A small correction, it's not that you will not have more than two auxiliary verbs, modal auxiliaries in a sentence. They do not combine with each other. That's the point to be noted here. Right? So you say she can sing, but you don't say she will sing. So four rules, always followed by the base form, same for all pronouns, take negatives and questions directly, and they don't combine with any other modal auxiliary. So remember these four rules when you are formulating or using any of the modal auxiliaries. So let's try to understand the real life uses of these four modal auxiliaries today. Let's begin with can. We all use it. Knowingly or unknowingly, we overuse can. Can is a word which we see every day. People sometimes use can in place of will. They use can in place of may. They use can in place of could. But if you understand the nuances, if you understand the actual rules where it should be used, you will reduce your usage of can. Right? Let's see some examples. Let's see different situations in which can be used. The first one is ability or lack of ability in present and future. So don't get confused. It's a simple sentence. Can is used to express ability. If someone asks you who can do this, you go and say I can do this. That means you are expressing your ability to do that work. It could be present ability or future ability. See, for example, she can dance well. So we are talking about her ability to dance well. Second one, I can meet you tomorrow at 3 p.m. What does that mean? That means if someone comes and asks you, are you free at 2 o'clock tomorrow? And you might already have a meeting fixed at 2 o'clock. You will say, 2 o'clock is difficult because I already have a meeting fixed. But I can meet you at 3 p.m. That means you are making yourself available and you are expressing your ability to meet that girl or boy at 3 p.m. tomorrow. This is ability in future. The first one is ability in the present. But what about ability in past? We have could for that. Let's go to that after completion of can. Okay, the second one is request and permission. And this is where we misuse or overuse can. Please remember, can should be used in only informal cases. When you are talking to your friend or relative or someone, if it is an informal conversation, you use can. Let's see some examples. If I say, can I borrow your pen? That means you are taking permission. Can I come in? You are taking permission. But this is an informal condition, informal kind of a request. When you know the other guy very well and you are kind of friends. But if you want to make it formal and more polite, you have could and may. We will see. Second example, can you close the door? You are asking someone to close the door. It is a request. It's again an informal request. If you want to request in a more polite and formal manner, you have to use could or may. So second usage is request or permission and informal. While when it is for informal requests or permissions. Third one, to give or not to give permission. You always see people saying, you cannot smoke here. You cannot park your vehicle here. That means you are denying permission there. Right? Or you can say, you can sit here. That means you are giving permission. So these are all permissions or not giving permissions. You can use my pen. You cannot smoke here. This is no parking. You cannot park your vehicle here. So these are situations where you want to give permission or do not want to give permission. Then you use the word can. Let me just revise can for you. Three use cases. Talks about ability in the present or future. For example, she can dance well. I can meet you tomorrow at 3 p.m. Request or permission. Informal request or permission. Can I borrow your pen? Can you close the door, please? There is no please there. Can you close the door? So these kind of situations where you have an informal kind of connectivity, connect with the other person, like your friend or someone. Third one, in cases of giving or denying permission, you can use my pen or you can sit here, you can park your vehicle here, you cannot smoke here. It could be negative or positive. Negative is denying permission, positive is giving permission. I hope you understand can now. Let's move to could. Could has kind of much wider uses compared to can. Let's see. So could is also used, like can, could is also used to express ability or lack of it. You might have ability or you might not have ability in the past. In this particular case, it is present or future. But if you are referring to ability or lack of it for a past situation, you use could. Shall we see some examples? I could read without glasses 2 years ago. Now you can see I am wearing glasses. But 2 years ago, I never had glasses. I could read myself without glasses. I could read books without glasses. Right? So this is my past ability which I don't have now. One more example. I could not eat properly yesterday as I had fallen sick. Yesterday I fell sick. So because of which I could not eat properly. But I can eat today. Today I have the ability to eat properly. But yesterday I did not have the ability. So that's why I use the word could. Because I fell sick. And could is also used for request. But the difference between request, could and request can is, here it is informal, here it is more formal and polite. And generally whenever you use could, it is followed or probably ends with please. I did not use it, but ideally we should use please also. So could we break for lunch please? Could we meet tomorrow? If someone calls you and asks for your appointment, and he is a senior, so you might want to say, you might want to hurt him and you are busy today. You will say, could we meet tomorrow please? So it's a formal or polite way of requesting. Third thing is past possibility that did not happen. Remember this. This is something we are already familiar with. If you have seen my video on conditional clauses, in third conditional, we have if plus subject plus past perfect in the if clause and subject plus would plus have plus V3 in the main clause. If you replace would with could, it becomes this. A past possibility that did not happen. We use this general example, right? If we had started on time, we would have reached. And you can also say we would have, if we had started on time, if they had started early, they could have reached on time. So you are not saying with certainty. You are saying it is a possibility. If only they had started early, they could have reached on time. Right? So the difference between would and could here, with would you are saying with certainty, but with could you are saying it as a possibility. Confused? I will just repeat it once again for you. When you say, if they had started early, they would have reached on time. That means you are saying with certainty that just because they did not start on time, they did not reach on time. Just because they did not start early, they did not reach on time. You are saying it with full certainty. But in this case, when you say, if they had started early, they could have reached on time. You are saying it is a possibility. The possibility or probability of them reaching early would have gone up if they had started early. The certainty level is less here. That's the difference between would and could. And fourth one, giving suggestion. But here you should use it only in the affirmative. That means no negatives. You will not use not here. For example, if someone is thinking of buying a new television and he comes to you and asks for your advice. So you will say, you could buy Sony television. If someone is looking for a smartphone, you might say, you could buy an Apple iPhone. So these are the suggestions which you are giving. So you use could. Right? So this is the fourth usage of could. Let's move on to may. May has limited uses, only two possibilities, two use cases. First one is permission, and proper formal permission. In classrooms, whenever a student seeks permission of the teacher to get into the class, she or he should say, may I come in? But we generally say, can I come in? Can I come in is informal, you should not use that. You should always use, may I come in? That is proper formal request. Even in offices or any formal places, you should always use, may I come in? Or, may I use your pen? So these are all proper formal requests. Second one is possibility in the present or future. Notice the word strong. You are talking about a future or present possibility. Let's see some example. It may rain today. I may not go to office tomorrow. So you are saying these two things are possible. You are saying these two things are possible, but the possibility is strong. When you use may, you are hinting that the possibility is strong. But when you are using might, the possibility is weak. We will come to that. So two use cases of may. First one is formal permissions. May I use your pen? May I come in? These kind of things. Second one is future or present situation with strong possibility. Like it may rain today. I may not go to office tomorrow. You are not saying with certainty. If you say I will not go to office tomorrow, you are saying it with certainty and that is your intent. But here your intent could be to go to office. You might want to go to office. But because of some niggle in your body, you are not feeling well, your health concerns or someone coming to your home. Because of some reasons, you feel that there is a strong possibility that you may not go to office tomorrow. Second one is only a possibility. When you are using will, you are saying it with certainty. Third one, might. Fourth one is might. So might also has two use cases. First one is possibility in the present or future, but weak. If you say it might rain today, it may rain today. So when you say it may rain today, you are saying that the possibility is more. When you say it might rain today, you are saying that the possibility is less. So when you want to hint that the possibility is weak or less, you use might. When you want to indicate that the possibility is strong or more, you use may. So you can replace may with might, might with may here. They are absolutely fine. But only that the degree of strength changes. May has higher strength and might has lower strength in terms of possibility. Same, I might not go to office tomorrow. Here, I may not go to office tomorrow. Here, the possibility is more. Here, the possibility is less. Second use case, past possibility again followed by have plus V3. Here also we have seen past possibility. Here also we are seeing past possibility. So he might have missed his flight. Or I might not have joined the meeting if I had not taken first flight. You're talking about a past situation and a past possibility. If I had not taken first flight, I might not have joined the meeting. Because I took first flight, because I had taken first flight, I had joined or I joined a meeting on time. You got it? If you put it in simple past and past perfect, I had taken first flight and I joined meeting on time. Two sentences. Now you are talking about a possibility if you had not taken first flight. What would have happened? So in that case you say, if I had not taken first flight, it is a situation. You are guessing the situation. But in reality you had taken first flight and you joined meeting on time. But you are thinking of a situation or a possibility of the past. If I had not taken first flight, I might not have joined meeting on time. So this is a past possibility. You generally follow it with have plus V3. Might is followed by have plus V3. Join is V1. Joined is V3. Here, miss is V1. Missed is V3. I hope you understand this lesson. I'll revise it just once again. So that you will not have any more confusions. Four modal auxiliaries, can, could, may and might. Can has three use cases, ability or lack of ability in the present or future situations. And second one is request or permission, which is informal, not formal. For formal request or permission, formal permission, you ideally use may. Formal request, you use could. Whenever you use could, try to use please at the end. Could I borrow your pen please? Things like that. Third one is giving or denying permission. You cannot smoke here. This is no parking. You cannot park your vehicle here. You can use my pen. Third case you are giving permission. And the first two cases you are not giving permission. You are denying permission. Similarly could. Similar to this. Ability or lack of it in the past. I could read without glasses 2 years ago. An example. Next one is request. But it is a polite and formal request, which is generally used in offices or with unknown people. Because with unknown people, we always act with formal or polite way. Could we break for lunch, please? Could we meet tomorrow, please? Something like that. And then past possibility that did not happen. Past possibility that did not happen. If they had started early, they could have reached on time. So what happened? They had not started early, because of which they did not reach on time. But you are thinking of a situation, if they had started early, they could have reached on time. Even then you are saying it is a possibility. If you want to say it with certainty, you use they would have reached on time. But still you are thinking, you are trying to say it as a possibility, so you are saying it like they could have reached on time. Fourth one is suggestion. Somebody comes to you and asks for your suggestion, you will always say, you could buy or you could do this, you could do that. This is a suggestion. And may is used for two use cases, formal permissions and possibility in the present and future, which is strong. If you say it may rain today, you are saying it with very strong possibility. Might also is used to indicate possibility in the present and future, but you want to indicate that the possibility is less. So if you say it might rain today, you are saying the possibility is less. Last one. Past possibility followed by have. again past possibility, just like this. So he might have missed his flight, or I might not have joined the meeting if I had not taken first flight. So what happened in the real life? You had taken first flight and you joined the meeting on time. But you are thinking of a situation, if you had not taken the first flight, you might have missed the meeting, or you might not have joined the meeting on time. So it is only a hypothetical kind of a situation. I hope you understand. Repeat this lesson if you haven't understood in the first instance. Very, very important. Understand these four auxiliaries, modal auxiliaries. I'll cover remaining auxiliaries in the next lesson. Thank you.